Hi Aquarius, welcome to another love reading of yours. This is for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. It is a general reading, guys. This may or may not resonate with every Aquarius watching this video. Some of the energies of the cards here can be flipped, so feel free to switch those energies and vice versa. Time is fluid, as you know. You could have dealt with this energy or will be dealing with in the near future. Okay. If you don't need a personal reading, all that information is going to be down below. With a Hierophant in reverse in your emotions, Aquarius, you could be dealing with someone who's non-committal, or you're dealing with someone who's whatever, same thing, commitment phobe or whatever, right? And this person's definitely thinking in their head, okay? This person definitely fears commitment. But I think with the Nine of Swords in reverse here, you're not stressing so much about it. You know, with the Magician, I also get that probably you're manifesting new things in life, or you're trying to manifest this person back into your life, anything, okay? Because with the Queen of Wands as the current situation here, it's like there is a lot of chemistry. Like I said, there's a lot of passion. The Queen of Wands, she knows what she wants, okay? She's very passionate about things, and she gets what she wants, okay? She gets up and gets what she wants. She's got that go-for-it vibe. I think one person out here is very determined to get the other person, okay? It's like, yeah, you can keep me on wait forever, but I'm still waiting. Let's see. With the Hermit in reverse in your attitude, you could be too isolated, okay? Or you're just trying to distract yourself from a lot of day-to-day activities, okay? Because you don't want to think about this person. Once this person, Page of Wands in reverse, right? They're unsure. There's a very energetic difference here. I always say this in most of my readings. That's one of the biggest issues in the readings, okay? You are probably expecting something stable, something solid, something committed from someone who's not ready to step up their game, or from someone who's just not ready for it. Two ways. One, either they can step up the game, but they don't want to because they want to explore the field, or they have too many options, or they're just not wanting to be in something serious, or they're just not ready for it, or they're just fearing commitment. They fear being into a serious relationship. Okay. I'll try for the Queen of Wands here. What is this Queen of Wands? Eight of Wands. See, there's someone here who's very, very passionate and wanting to move things forward. It's like I'm hell-bent on moving things forward. This has to move forward. Eight of Wands. Someone wants quick movement, okay? Someone's like wanting to communicate, okay? This is a lot of passionate communication, back and forth, back and forth. Eight of Wands is also very determined energy. And along with a Magician, it's like, dude, I will do everything under the sun to get this to get this to happen, or make this shit happen. Again, you're very attracted to this person, okay? And so is this person attracted to you. But you see them as the Queen of Wands. Why is the Magician here? Queen of Wands in reverse. So, why is the Queen of Wands in reverse? The Queen of Wands in reverse. Two cards. I don't want two cards. Time for the Queen of Wands in reverse. Page of Pentacles in reverse. Okay, so with the Magician, Queen of Wands in reverse, and the Page of Pentacles in reverse. So what I feel is that, yes, you're manifesting this person, okay? But again, you're not wanting to be the one who wants to take action. You're constantly either procrastinating or you're just holding back. You're making things, this is a lot of manipulation, okay? It's like, yes, I want this person logically, you know, you're like, yes, this is the one I want, okay? But I think you're holding back. You're not taking proper action towards this person, or again, this could be Queen of Wands in reverse is also someone who tries to play with other people's emotions, okay? I don't think you're dealing with someone like that. I think you're the one doing this because you want this person to come out of isolation, you want this person to make a decision, or you want to get this person to talk to you. It's almost like a technique that you're doing, okay? It's almost like a technique to get this person to talk to you. Like you want to talk, but I think there's minimal communication, okay? Or there's just no proper communication going on. You're not being as aggressive as you were before, okay? But yeah, you're sure as hell manifesting this person back. Why is this Four of Swords here? Try for the Four of Swords. King of Swords. Give me one more card for King of Swords. High Priestess in reverse wanted to come up before also. You're dealing with someone who has a very hard time trusting their intuition. you know what I'm getting with the Four of Swords and the King of Swords here? This person is taking a break, and I think they know that you're very, very sure about what you want. They know you're very clear about what you want, okay? And this time, in their logic, either this person wants to make a very logical approach towards this situation, okay? They want to leave their emotions on the side and deal only with the facts and logic, or this person sees you as someone who's like, you know what, like giving them an ultimatum, okay? Like, this is what it is. I mean, yes, is it a yes or a no, in or out? Or they could have been in the silent treatment, or they could have been taking a break because you could have cut them out with the King of Swords here. I don't feel this is them. I feel this is you. Like, you could have given them an ultimatum, okay? It's like, what do you want to do? Are you in this with me or not? Black or white, I don't want no gray area. And now with the High Priestess in reverse here, this person is completely confused. They're drinking her time out, but with the High Priestess in reverse here, I feel this person's finding a really hard time to trust their intuition. They're trusting their logic over intuition. They could be listening to other people's opinions, or this could be someone who just cares a lot about what other people have to say about them. They don't even know themselves. The High Priestess in reverse is someone who doesn't know themselves at all. But yeah, I think this person fears communication because you are in that energy of like, you know what? You could have cut them out very well. You could have very well cut them out, okay? And now they're like on this break. But they're not doing the work that they need to. I mean, they're still stuck in their head. I don't know how good this break, time out is going to do. Why am I Hierophant in reverse? Ace of Pentacles. See, there's a delay in this brand new beginning because someone's not committing. Someone's not wanting to be in a serious relationship. Serious. But someone's just not wanting to be in a high level of commitment, or just not wanting to be exclusive with other person. That's why there's a delay. Could be someone who's delaying this entire show. Okay, why is Ace of Pentacles in reverse here? Hangman in reverse. Because there's someone who's lacking that way of... The Hangman in reverse is someone very stubborn, first of all. You're dealing with someone who has a very one-sided perspective, a very one-sided view, or you're just dealing with someone who's keeping you on hold and you're just going through a limbo over and over and over again, okay? The same negative pattern is repeating itself. And it could be very well because this person is stuck in their head, okay? So yeah, this person could be putting in a limbo. That's one of the reasons why things are delayed, and because they're commitment phobic, okay? So yeah, the Hangman in reverse is someone, you know, who's very stubborn. They lack perspective. They lack seeing things from the other person's point of view, okay? They don't have a lot of, they're very empathetic, you know, or they're not very compassionate, or they're more about themselves, okay? And the Hangman in reverse, you could be dealing with someone who will temporarily sacrifice their happiness just to prove how right they were. Could be you, could be them. Why is the Eight of Swords here? Okay, so with the Two of Pentacles and the Strength in reverse, this person is almost very close to giving up, okay? With the Two of Pentacles, this person is constantly juggling the idea of whether they want this with you or not, okay? They're constantly in their head. But with the Two of Pentacles, this person could be juggling two people, which I don't get. But I feel they're juggling the situation, or they're trying to weigh the pros and cons about what should I do, but they're still stuck in their head. The Eight of Swords is an energy that someone's paralyzed by fear, okay? So they're not really looking at something logically. They're stuck in their head. They're not opening the blindfold and seeing things for what they are. They don't have a reality check about things. And this is someone who's coming in their own way, okay? And they're constantly juggling, and that's one of the reasons why they're so indecisive. They're refusing to see the reality. And with the Strength in reverse here, this person's taking the easy way out. They know they need to make a brave move. They know they need to make a bold move towards you, apologize or whatever it is, okay? But they're not. They're taking the easy way out. For them, it's like, oh, I'm so trapped in my head, I can't make a decision, I'm so indecisive, oh, there's so much to do, blah, blah, blah. They're taking the easy way out. And you know that. You know that you're already dealing with someone. Well, you know the reason for the delay in the commitment. Devil in reverse. Someone's finding it very hard to release their demons. Why is the Nine of Swords in reverse here? Why is the Nine of Swords in reverse here? I think you both are not stressing so much about the situation right now, okay? Or you're just, it's like, you know what? More time passes by, right? And I think you're both accepting the situation, like, okay, there's an issue here, but none of you are doing anything about it. You want to. You want to, and you clearly know what you're dealing with, right? But it's this person who's the issue here. It's this person who's the problem here, okay? They're not making a decision. They're scared of that truthful communication, that clear communication, you know, like cutting through the bullshit, okay? That's why they're choosing to listen to their something that's making them more comfortable rather than, you know, listen to their intuition, okay? They're blocking their intuition right now. They're taking the easy way out, like I said. And I think with the Nine of Swords in reverse and the Judgment here, I think either both of you are going to see the light at the end of tunnel and there is going to be a reconciliation. I think that's what's happening. I think you're both going to, the stress is going to get a little lesser. Okay? And I think you guys are going to land up with a Judgment, with a second chance out here. You both want this anyways. Three of Cups in reverse. Or if not, then it could also be that, you know what, you both have acceptance of a situation, you're both not stressing about the situation as much as we did before. And with the Judgment here, you're both going to make a final call, or one of you is at least going to make a final call. And I think that's going to be you. Try to have a comment in reverse. Queen of Cups. Try with the Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups. I saw this. I'm gonna take this. The Six of Swords. See, I told you, right? Strong chances that you are going to walk away. There is a lot of love here, right? But with the Queen of Cups here, I feel you have a lot of love for this person, unconditional love, right? But your cup is shut. Your cup is shut. Your attitude towards this person is, I think you're isolating yourself too much with the Hermit in reverse, okay? I don't think you're coming out of isolation. I think you're isolating yourself too much. You've completely, you know, it's like, you know what, from the Hermit, right? From the Hermit energy, if you stay too much into that, that's when it gets in reverse, because then you start overthinking a situation, okay? And that's when there is a lack of action, and then you start overthinking, overanalyzing a situation, and that's when it starts a negative spiral. And that's what's happening with you. You're still shut down. You're still not offering your emotions to this person. You're trying to keep yourself very busy in your day-to-day work, okay? But with the Six of Swords, I think you want to move away. I'm not getting you want to move towards this person. I'm getting you want to move away from this person. You're trying to mentally distance yourself from this person. You could be living at a distance from this person, all right? There could be distance between you both, right? But I think your attitude is, you know what, I need to separate my emotions from this person right now till this person doesn't make up their mind, because they're too indecisive, and with the Eight of Swords, they're all in their head. It's like the Four of Swords, they're in their head, okay? They probably want this communication, but again, they're not being able to trust their intuition that, yes, this is the right time and I need to talk about it. They're just not doing anything about it except staying in their head. Alright, try for the Page of Wands in reverse. Why is the Justice here? Knight of Pentacles. Alright, so this person in that attitude, they have the Page of Wands in reverse, the Justice, and the Knight of Pentacles. I really like this. So what I'm seeing is that this person wants to balance out the situation, okay? They want a balance, they want an equal give and take, okay? They want to rectify a situation, make a bad situation good. I like that. But again, with the Page of Wands in reverse here, you're dealing with someone who is consciously or subconsciously, however, right, this is someone who's stalling progress, okay? It's almost like with the Knight of Pentacles here, you're dealing with someone who's, anyways, they were very slow moving, okay? So that could be one of your issues of whether, you know, you always never trusted this person, you know, like, are they even serious about me? Yes, they are, but the only biggest problem out here is that the Knight of Pentacles here, okay? This is the slowest moving energy of the deck. This is someone who's not on a horse. They're not even moving. Okay, they're at a standstill out here. They're just waiting. This is a very methodical person. Okay, so if you're trying to rush into something, Aquarius, I don't think it's going to happen. If you want something now, it won't. It won't. So your problem is that this person's coming into slowly, right? And that's one of the reasons why with the Six of Swords here, you are feeling, it's almost like it's driving you nuts. And you feel the need to move yourself away, take yourself away from this. But all this person needs is time. You're dealing with someone very immature here, Aquarius. Very immature. You're showing up as someone very mature out here, okay? And that's what they're afraid of, that they have to have this communication with someone very mature out here. But yeah, for them, I don't even think they have the courage, the guts to make that effort towards you. And that's why they're constantly juggling, all right? Do I want this? Do I not? They want this. In their attitude, with the Knight of Pentacles and the Justice here, I really like this. They want to be fair to you, okay? They want to give you what you deserve, okay? This is someone very slow moving, right? So they want, when they come and write, they want to make sure they come and correct. The offer that they give or when they're coming towards you, this is someone who wants something stable and committed, all right? So if you are in that impression that they don't, they do. This is just someone, it's their own issue, okay? They're coming in their own way and I don't think you can do anything about it, Aquarius. I think you could have tried a lot in the past. And now when I see the Queen of Wands in reverse here, I feel that you're someone who's just completely pulling back your energies because this person could, you could have given this person like a lot of chances. You could have tried to, you know, get them to do something, right? But you can't, you can take the horse to the water, but you can't make it drink it, right? Because see, with the Page of Wands in reverse here, I think this is a person who's intentionally or unintentionally stalling further progress, okay? I think they're doing it unintentionally. I don't think they're doing it on purpose to, you know, to hurt you. I don't think it's not there in their intentions anymore. It's unintentional, okay? Because, again, you're dealing with someone who does not, they're not ready to step up the game, Aquarius. Why is the Wheel of Fortune here? You, on the other hand, right, I think you have completely, your attitude towards this person is that you just want to keep this person at arm's length, okay? There's no either. Yes, it could be where you've been enlightened to a fact, okay, you've come out of isolation and you're ready to talk, but I don't think that is the case here. I think you are completely isolating yourself. You're isolating yourself too much, to an extent, when it comes to this person. You have a lot of love for this person. You do. You have unconditional love for this person. But I think for you, it's like your attitude is the best thing for me to do right now is move away from this person. Even if it's temporary, it's the best thing to do right now. Okay? It's almost like you want to give this person time. Fair enough, right? Why is the Wheel of Fortune here as the likely outcome? Where is the Wheel of Fortune here as the likely outcome? World. I think you guys are going to end up starting a new cycle, a new chapter, okay? With the world here, I think the more you give this person time, right, I think this person is going to learn their lessons. These are both very good guys. You're going to successfully start, you finished a cycle with this person and with the world here and the Wheel of Fortune here, this is endings and new beginnings. You're ready to start a new chapter with this person, okay? I think this person is finally going to make a move with the Justice here. This is commitment, okay? This is something fair. Marriage, whatever, right? But they're coming in very slowly, right? But they're just going to take some time. Ow. Because again, with the Page of Wands in reverse here, right? Someone very, very immature. They're going to take some time to grow up. So if you're ready to wait, it's coming in. World and Wheel of Fortune. Luck is on your side, guys. Definitely. On your side, Aquarius. It is on your side. Things are going to go your way. The wheel's going to start rolling, okay? It's going to be your wish. By the time this person comes in, do you want to hop on or not? They're going to take their time. I'm not going to lie. They're going to take their time when they come in, right? Because that's the Knight of Pentacles here. You, on the other hand, you're probably catching up on their energies because you feel that they're just not making a move towards you. Agreed. That's what the Knight of Pentacles can do to you. But they're coming in. They're coming in. They want a second chance with the Judgment here, okay? They want a reconciliation. Going to be up to you. You have a new beginning coming. So that's what I have for you, Aquarius. I hope this reading resonates with you. Leave your comments below and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.